Hello, welcome to Paul's Takes, and today we're going to discuss Jeep. Jeeps have been like, I don't know, when I think of a Jeep, I think rugged, outdoorsy, tough, four-wheel drive, crawling around the mud, climbing mountains, polluting, using lots of gas and all that stuff, being kind of jarry. And then when Fiat bought out Chrysler, I was shocked. For one, I didn't realize Fiat was big enough to buy Chrysler. Chrysler seemed to me a bigger company. And then Fiat, what do Fiats make? Little tiny cars? How are they going to make Jeeps and Dodge Rams and stuff? Well, obviously, they're going to work with existing people working at Dodge. But nonetheless, I didn't know if they were going to bring any value to the table because, I don't know, they seem like a smaller, lamer company. But I have to say, when they did take over, the new Jeeps are pretty darn nice. They definitely improved. They're more Jeepy than the Jeeps, I think. Yeah, they had more of a Jeepy feel, which you kind of sense was a Jeep. It looked more so. It looked Americana. So how does Fiat, which is, what country are they? Let me go check. So I was right. So it was Fiat that bought out Chrysler, and Fiat's from Italy. What? An Italian company buying out an American giant company. Delicious. Strange, right? So now, obviously, Italians are Italian, and they have good design taste. They make Lamborghinis and all the cool cars. But I wouldn't call them Americana. But the Jeeps are. They look great. I love them. So going into the future, though, where everything is becoming electric, I would think that Jeep would be the last to go electric. They just seem so, just petro, what they call it again? What's the term? Whatever, they're gasoline-powered vehicles that I thought would be the last holdout for the gas-powered vehicles. ICE vehicles, that's what they're called. ICE, internal combustion engines. So I thought they would be the last to go. But apparently Italy is very proactive in the electrical vehicles industry, or going to be so, and they're saying by 2022, every single Jeep in the lineup will be some sort of either fully electric or a hybrid. So that's pretty impressive, and I guess even the newer Jeeps now are much cleaner and better, more reliable, but get better gas mileage than the old ones, because the old ones were terrible. That to me was the biggest holdup to getting a Jeep, because by the look and by the image, you know, I like Jeeps. I've actually owned three Jeeps. I never had a Wrangler. I had a Jeep Compass, Jeep Patriot, and a Jeep Cherokee. And I liked them all. They were all good vehicles. I had no problems with them. Not really. I mean, you know, some mechanical issues, but none of them ever left me stranded anywhere. You know, they're tough. Good four-wheel drive systems. But I wonder how reliable will they be off-roading? And two, how will the Jeepy people accept it? Because I'm not thinking green when I'm thinking Jeep. When they put those big tires on there and they modify the motors and they're making a bunch of smoke out the back. Will the electric vehicles, for one, will they be easily modifiable as like the present Jeeps are? I don't know. Good question. I'm curious. That to me is very interesting. I'm curious to see how that goes. So let's just stay tuned. I just wanted to bring that up because I thought for sure Jeep would be the last. But I'm glad they're not, though. I mean, truthfully, I like Jeeps. They're a little overpriced to me. But I like them, and I would like them to be better gas mileage. So, hey, if I can get a reliable 20 miles per gallon in a Jeep Wrangler, I might, and if I could afford one, I might consider one because I like them. But to me, I got to have at least 20 miles per gallon in any vehicle. Just in general. Because I don't trust the gas prices. And if they got going up, it's going to be expensive. And if it stays the way it is, that's fine. I could do 20. Well, that's all I got today. Just want to bring that up and see what you thought about Jeeps being electric. Is that a good idea? Or should they stay gas for as long as they possibly can? Thanks for watching, and make sure you hit subscribe. And hit like, and thanks for your support on Paul's Take. And that was my take on the new Jeeps from Fiat.